excuse my father. He's labeled as a crybaby. He cries so much. He cries in every situation. So it's why my man is crying right now, but he's a big crybaby.
I'm Gary Striewski, ESPN host, son of a military veteran, and proud homeowner. And I'm looking forward to going one-on-one with one of the most exciting young quarterbacks in the National Football League today, Justin Fields, from his home base in Kennesaw, Georgia. Take a look. Justin Fields, through the last couple of years, you have been everywhere, state to state, across the country. Man, how does it feel to be back home?
Definitely awesome, you know, just coming back home and, you know, being able to spend time with my family. So there's definitely been a lot of memories that have been created in this house. You know, I just kind of get that homey feeling, you know, every time I come back.
Can you touch a little bit on what it was like growing up in your household with your father having the military experience?
He was definitely very hard on me in terms of how I treated other people outside of this house, my respect for others, and made me into the man I am today. So I'm definitely grateful for that.
This one right here is my junior year. And this was another Player of the Year award. And this was pretty much given to the most valuable player.
Are these the same things?
So many awards that he can't keep up with them all. Must be nice.
Oh yeah, so they are the same awards.
Even when he was a freshman, I mean, you would watch those scrimmages at Georgia. A lot of people didn't see that the parents were able to see. I mean, you know, he was hanging with the big boys. He's got an opportunity to go to the NFL. That's just a blessing for us to see him on the next level and live out a childhood dream.
Your son, who he was a little boy playing ball in the park, and you got some kid running around talking about, "I'm Justin Fields, I'm Justin Fields, I'm just," you know,
We saw big, tough Pablo shed a tear at realizing that kids nowadays look up to Justin. That was a cool moment. That was awesome.
Excuse my father. He's labeled as a crybaby. He cries so much. He cries in every situation. So it's why my man is crying right now, but he's a big crybaby.
You're entering what's going to be the absolute prime of your life as a professional quarterback. You're going to be in a new city. What will you absolutely need to have in that home?
I wouldn't say there's a specific thing I need to bring with me. I mean, I would say the only thing I need is my guy Uno. Like a month before my sophomore season, so I mean, basically, you know, I lived alone in Columbus, Ohio, so I really got Uno to, you know, to keep me company when I was spend a lot of time home, you know, by myself, just kind of watching films.
Uno is safe, the family is safe, so those are the two most important things. But you got to get out of your house quick, and you can only grab one thing. What's it gonna be?
I would say either my game-worn jerseys or my, you know, helmets that I wore in the game. So I think those are pretty valuable and definitely pretty pricey, so I would definitely have to grab those.
When I ask you how you protect stuff that means a lot to you, what's the first thing that comes to mind?
I think you just have to have your people around you and around that stuff that you trust, around the things that you value most. You have to have the people around it that you value most.
Like, what are some of those memories that you're gonna miss going into your own, buying your first house, that you're not gonna be able to have there at home in Kennesaw?
I guess my family, to be honest with you. So, I mean, I think I'll have everything I need, of course, but it's literally just my family not being able to be there with me. And of course, you know, they're gonna visit a lot, but every time, you know, I come back home, I just really think back on those moments and I, you know, cherish those moments and I think they were really, you know, big parts of my life.